Onshape's unique data management methodology means anyone with the right permission can always see the latest in-progress iteration of a design. However, in some cases, this can lead to confusion. Opening the top-level assembly of this engine, we see several components appear to be missing. This is because, even though there have not been any real changes since the release, a previous user interrogated the model and hid several parts. They chose not to restore the assembly to a clean state before leaving the document. After fixing, I'll just quickly create a version. New in this release, you can enable workspace protections. Workspace protection effectively limits what edits can be made to a specific branch, whereby changes can only take effect through a merge operation. Notice the toolbar at the top has been hidden and instead simply gives a message indicating that a protection is enabled. You can move and hide components just as the previous user had done to interrogate your model. But notice this time, when the document is reloaded using a refresh, the state of those components is restored. These types of changes are limited to the user and the session. If you wish to make a change, you'll have to use a design branch. The new branch created will not have protections enabled, and therefore will be editable. We will quickly make some basic changes on this B2 branch. Changes can then be merged into the protected workspace, but there are some additional safety measures in place for continuity. The B1 branch was actually created from an earlier point of this design, after which some changes were made on the main branch. As a result, Onshape will provide a warning and block this merge from occurring due to the discrepancies. To resolve this issue, you would first have to merge main into B1 to reconcile those previous changes. Then B1 could be merged into main safely. However, the B2 branch was just created, and therefore contains all of the changes that had occurred on main, in addition to the changes of its own. Therefore, the merge operation will be allowed. The resulting main workspace will still be in a protected state, but now reflects the changes that were made from B2. Protected workspaces do not impact your release management process in any way, as it is still possible to create and approve release candidates even from a protected workspace. Finally, should you ever need to directly edit your protected branch, workspace protection can easily be disabled in the same way you turned it on. Workspace protection allows for more deliberate control of how changes can be made to a product without ever locking or removing a design team's permission to edit. This means you can still rapidly iterate in a truly collaborative manner and design your products fearlessly.
The Derived feature enables you to insert parts or sketches from another part studio or document to use as a basis for further design work or to minimize repetition. By default, the Derived part is inserted at the origin of the part studio, and now you can choose where the part should be located by selecting explicit or implicit make connectors. The origin of the derived part is then placed at the origin of the make connector. If a part can be inserted in more than one orientation or the origin is in the wrong place, add one or more make connectors to the base part definition. Then changing the placement type to base make connector will place points on each origin. To see those make connectors and to add them to the part studio, select Include Make Connectors. Clicking a point will move the part, and the place where that point should be located can be changed if needed. Now, the correct way to place this foot on the opposite leg of this frame would be to use the Mirror Part feature. However, if you create a second derived feature and try to add the same part and the same configuration, the derived feature will fail. This is intentional to reduce mistakes and improve performance. To add multiple instances of the same part, they should be added to the same derived feature. The base make connector selection applies to all instances of the derived part, but each individual location can be edited by clicking on the make connector icon. The new locations option in the Derived feature saves a lot of extra time and effort.
A new continuity option has been added for loft guide curves. This loft feature was created using three guide curves, one at the top, one in the middle, and a sketch at the bottom. The surface is then mirrored to create the other side of the geometry. Upon interrogation, we notice a small seam at the location of the mirror. This is because the curvature transition is not perfect at that location. It is even more apparent enabling our zebra stripes, as we are able to see a jog at the location of the seam. We can correct this using the new continuity condition. Editing the loft feature, we can change the continuity at the sketch edge to use the type normal to guide. This will ensure that it meets exactly normal at the bottom edge where the seam of the mirror occurs. This will yield a much smoother transition in this particular example of a loft.
Tables in drawings can now be created by pasting cells from Google Sheets or Microsoft Excel. Data from other sources, such as a configuration table, can also be used, but the data must be formatted first. Paste the CSV file into a spreadsheet, then edit the values or apply cell formatting such as height, width, or merge. Select the required cell range and copy. Then paste onto a drawing sheet by either right-clicking and selecting Paste as Table or using the Control or Command V shortcut. Any further cell formatting can then be applied.
You can now easily create linear Centermark patterns in Onshape drawings. Select the Linear option in the Centermark dialog. After picking subsequent holes for your pattern, the Centermark will correctly align. Connecting lines can be created as well if the option is enabled. An improvement has been made to the Release Candidate dialog. When creating a release, you may now filter in the top right corner by items that require attention. These may be elements with warnings, just worth noting, or actual errors that would prevent the release from occurring. As you correct these issues, the items are automatically removed from the filter. This improvement will reduce scrolling and searching, especially in larger release candidates.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.